Euzubillahimineşşeytanirracim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Dear students, class 12th, Assalamu alaikum. Our today's topic is informal organization. Yesterday, we discussed formal organization. And today we are discussing informal organization. Dear students, interaction among the people at work gives rise to a network of social relationships among employees. That relationship is called informal organization, or we can say informal organizations refers to the relationship between people in an organization based on not on formal hierarchy but on personal attitudes, whims, likes, and so on. Informal organization emerges from within the formal organization when people interact beyond their officially defined rules. When people have frequent contacts, they cannot be forced into a rigid formal structure. For example, such groups are formed with common interests. Maybe those who take part in cricket matches on Sundays met in the cafeterias for coffee, or interested in dramas, etc. They form some relationship in matches, in cafeterias, in other places. Informal organization has no written rules, is fluid in form and scope, and does not have fixed line of communication. Rather, they are based on their interaction and friendship. They tend to form groups which show conformity in terms of interests. Informal organization can be better understood with the help of following features. An informal organization originates from within the formal organization as a result of personal interaction among employees. Number two, the standards of behavior evolve from group norms rather than officially laid down rules and regulations. Number three, independent channels of communication without specified direction or follow-up information are developed by group members. Number four, it emerges simultaneously and is not deliberately created by the management. Number five, it has no definite structure or form because it is a complex network of social relationships among members. There are some advantages of informal organization. Number one is prescribed lines of communication are not followed. Thus, the informal organization leads to faster spread of information as well as quick feedback. Number two, it helps to fulfill the social needs of the members and allows them to find like-minded people. This enhances their job satisfaction since it gives them a sense of belongings in the organization. Number three, it contributes towards fulfillment of organizational objectives by compensating for inadequate cases in the formal organization. For example, employees' reactions towards plans and policies can be tested through the informal network. There are some disadvantages of informal organization also. Number one, when an informal organization spreads rumors, it becomes a destructive force and goes against the interest of the formal organization. Number two, the management may not be successful in implementing changes if the informal organization opposes them. Such resistance to change may delay or restrict growth. On the basis of above points, yesterday's discussion and today's discussion, there is a difference between formal and informal organization. Informal organization is created to achieve predetermined objectives, while as informal organization has no predetermined objectives. Formal organization refers to well-defined authority, responsibility, and relationship, while as informal organization is based on human emotions and sentiments. Formal organization, formal relations are well planned and created deliberately. And in informal organization, relations originate automatically. In formal organization, there is a prescribed chain of communication, and in informal, there is no prescribed chain of communication. In formal organization, there is prescribed chain of command, which is followed for all acts. And in informal organization, the chain of command is based on sentiments of members. In formal organization, there is rigid structure, and in informal organization, there is flexibility. And in formal organization, managers provide leadership to the workers. And in informal organization, leader is elected among members. In formal organization, formal authority to everyone in the position is given. And in informal organization, it gives informal authority to the members. That's all for today. Goodbye.